In this video, we are going to talk about the date picker. We will be going through configuring the date picker to determine how it is displayed and stored. Then, we will show you on how to search for records using the date picker too. We will also talk about how you can sort the records based on date at the end. This is a sample form which contains two date pickers. We will show you on how to customize the date picker. One named as departure, the other one named as arrival. At the moment, we have only defined its ID and label. All other options and advanced options are left intact or blank. Let's observe a data entry. By default, date will be displayed in month, day, year format. Get back to the form design. Let's try to define the display format attribute. We will try DD, MM, YY format. This is the database table view. As you can see here, whatever date values that we see in the browser and here are the same. Get back to the form design. This time, we will define the data format attribute. We are going to store the selected date differently into the database. As you can see here, the store value is now following the data format that we have just defined. Edit the same record again. You can see that the date picker transformed the stored value that is of YY, MM, DD format to the display format, DD, MM, YY. Just to recap, this is the configurations to the date picker that we have done so far. We are going to the second part of the tutorial now. We are going to add date filter to the data list. Add departure into the filters. Select date filter. When configuring the date filter, we will need to make sure that it will search using the correct format. We will need to define the data format to be the same as the one in the form. We will also change the display format to make things consistent here. Remember, the display format is optional. So, by choosing this date in this DD, MM, YY format, it will eventually search as YY, MM, DD format. This will only match this single record as the others don't match. Next, we going to change this filter to the date range filter. We will use back the same formats. Try it out in the actual user view. Alright, it works. We are done with the second part of this tutorial. Next part, we are going to show you how to sort the records. Here's the sample records that we have entered. We are going to sort using the arrival column. In the data list builder, edit the arrival column to make it sortable. It is unsorted now. Now we are sorting it in ascending order. And now in descending order. One important thing to note here is that sorting is done based on the stored data value. In this case, YY, MM, DD format. This will bring us to the next part of the tutorial. As you can see here, across the app design, we are trying to use the DD, MM, YY format, and the data list is not following this format. So, we are going to show you how to change the data list column value to follow the date format that we want here. In the data list builder, edit the departure date column, set the formatter to date formatter. Configure the set of formats accordingly. Repeat the same steps for arrival column. refresh the user view. Bingo! The list is now displaying using the date format that we want. Let's try to sort the arrival column again to see if it still works. This is in ascending order, and this is descending order. We hope that you can now configure your data picker to show, to store, to filter, and to sort correctly now. Thank you.